Welcome to Performance Staff Pro Series, a collaborative forum where working professionals can share together their knowledge, experience, hopefully a little wisdom, but most importantly, their collective passions for live entertainment. I'm Mark Pawsey, and today I am talking once again with Diego, Madison, and Emma, members of MDC3, the newly crowned winners of MBC's World of Dance. Welcome.
Hi. What's up?
What was the first thing that went into your head when you realized you had won MBC's World of Dance?
Probably just like thinking to myself, is this really happening right now? Because we've tried to be on the show for so long and it's been our dream to even be on it. So to know we've made it through the whole process and have not felt one feeling of defeat throughout the whole thing was really crazy for me.
Yeah, there was so many great acts on the show, and to know that we were both top four and like ended up winning, that just crazy to us and almost felt like a dream.
For me, what was going through my head was, oh my gosh, we just won $1 million. So that was pretty cool, but it was more like how accomplishing it felt to actually have won such a big show with these two.
And what was the feeling inside you? What did you feel?
I felt really nervous standing up there because there was only one more act holding us back from the win. So just seeing those three scores, like with that big dramatic, like tension and music really added up to the moment. So it was just such a rush when we found out we won. Yeah, a lot of adrenaline.
So last time we met, you talked about keeping your focus and staying confident. How did you manage to stay focused throughout the competition?
Probably just focusing on that it's a competition and need to be on our best game possible. So to just know that we're competing for $1 million was probably our top priority.
Yeah, we actually filmed the finals a day earlier than we were supposed to film. So that threw us off a lot. So we really had to stay on track and stay focused.
I have a lot of trouble focusing, and I've always had like trouble focusing since I was little. So music helped me a lot, which like if I was really nervous, I just put in my headphones, and I remember for them, I wouldn't talk. I would just stretch and put in my headphones. And I was almost a completely different person the day of the competition.
Did you get nervous? And if so, how did you deal with the nerves on the night and through the process of the competition?
She got really nervous for semis.
It was the worst feeling because before we filmed our semifinals, we ended up going back to the hotel in between like our rehearsals and our filming. So when we went back, we weren't able to eat. And me and Maddie actually just watched a movie. And we needed to calm down for a second. And then when we went back, it was like game time and we were really ready. And then I guess we just gave it our all. It was definitely the most nervous I've ever been in my life performing for something. So that was really difficult.
Yeah, I feel like just staying together like really calmed our nerves as well. And like really like holding each other's hands and just feeling each other's energy.
What do you think was the hardest adjustment in moving from the studio recordings to the main stage? Because that's such a leap.
I definitely think it's all like the like screens in the back and all the lighting, the new stage that we're not used to.
Yeah, the stage, the bottom of the stage, like where you're standing, also lights up with like stuff. So it gets confusing. Like you have to know your direction, not like based off of the parts on the stage, but based off the audience. And we're also dancing like on a circle. So it was different than the acts in the studio because the studio is like square. And so we had to use our space much different.
So talk me through the actual day. How did you prepare on the day?
I think we got there. We did one rehearsal before and then we started filming. We watched all like the other acts. It was very quick.
We were very tired from the day before because we had to do 5 run-throughs of the dance. On a stage back to back, and we had the mentoring and a really big interview, so we were beat up by the next day, but we just had to push through. It was a really long day, and it was like the night before our actual performance, so we definitely didn't get much sleep, but it was all worth it.
Absolutely. How do you relax before either this event or a big competition? How do you relax?
Probably doing anything possible to like get my mind off my nerves is really important to stay calm before performance.
Yeah, some people like to keep running their dances and like stay warmed up, but if I get like overstretched or I keep going through my dance, then sometimes I'll dance worse. So I just need to wait for like a few hours before the moment to then start getting in it and hold off before ahead of time.
Yeah, I feel like just saving my energy and taking care of my body for the night.
What's the process you use to develop your characters in your storytelling when you're not playing yourselves?
Yeah, I feel like Shannon always like talks to us about our character and how to portray that to the audience. So we really try to internalize that character.
And how did it feel when you saw J-Lo in tears, that emotional?
Definitely like we did our job, because that was one of our main goals coming into semifinals, was such an emotional piece. And to know that it touched her the way we wanted it to was really accomplishing to us.
What did you learn from the judges on the show?
They gave me a lot more confidence than I had before, because I've always thought like I'm the younger one in the trio, so I have to dance up to them because they're like my big sister and big brother. So it's a lot of pressure as well, dancing up to this different level. So I'm just glad I was able to like fit in with them, if that makes sense, when the judges didn't like, if I got called out by a judge, I would have felt really bad. So I think that made me feel a bit better. I think they also reassured me that I could make dance like a professional career for a long time, because they pointed out that the three of us are individually just as good as we are together, which was good to hear.
Yeah, they always had something great to say about us, and that just gave us so much life and love because we looked up to them a lot, so it was just an honor.
And what is next for you? What's next for you now?
We plan on staying a trio for as long as we can, and we definitely have some jobs lined up. We just did something for the American Heart Association, which was really cool. And we're doing a music video for Blake McGrath's new single coming out soon, which we're excited for.
What advice could you give someone ahead of a large audition or competition?
I would say that training is like the number one thing if you want to pursue dance, because that's what molds you as a dancer when you're older. And you will have some bad days, you will have some good days, but all of those mistakes and failures are part of the process.
I would say don't let the nerves get to your head, because that can throw you off the game and make you really like shaky on stage. So just know that you're going to survive even if you don't win or do your best, as long as you're having fun. I would say just try to be yourself and don't try to be anyone else, because when you're unique, that's when you stand out the most.
One word to describe your journey on the show.
Grateful.
Blessed. Surreal.
Emma, Madison, and Diego, thank you for sharing a small part of yourselves within our Performer Staff Pro Series, and for helping to keep entertainment alive, nourished, and full of hope. And for those watching, please dream big, and while you're dreaming, look out for more Performer Staff Pro Series coming your way real soon. Thank you, Emma. Thank you, Madison. Thank you, Diego. Doodle pip.